today's video, I'm going to be ranking all of the palettes I tried in the last 2 months from worst to best. I feel like less palettes have launched this year because normally you don't have to combine 2 months worth of palettes, and I've done that a couple times already this year because in June, I literally only tried 3 palettes. And then this past July, I have tried 9 palettes. So let's go ahead and get into it, starting off with number 12, the worst palette that I tried this month. So these I gave a semi-positive review on, but the longer that I've had them and the more that I've used them, to be quite honest, the less that I've liked them. So here is 12, my least favorite color story, believe it or not. This is the ColourPop Shell Shocked Pressed Powder Palette. This is from the Opal of My Eye collection. I love the aesthetic of this palette, love the packaging of this palette. Unfortunately, don't love the quality of the palette. Now, it's okay, the mattes are fine, they don't have a ton of pigment, but whatever. It's mostly the Super Shock shadow in here that I was really excited about, but honestly, it creases so quickly, my makeup just doesn't look as good when I wear them. The shimmer shades are a little lackluster, if you ask me. They just don't give me enough of what I want. A little bit on the messy side, just not a great palette from ColourPop. It's not the end of the world, these aren't terrible palettes. Did not try a terrible palette this month. Just don't like the way that these are wearing, particularly this color story I haven't reached for as often. I haven't been as motivated to reach for it, and I thought this would be my favorite, but it's a color story I just don't find myself reaching for because I don't like the shimmers in it. I do like the mattes, but that brings me to number 11, which is the What the Shell palette. So this is the other one that is ranking above because I've used this color story more. I've been more tempted to reach for it. It, believe it or not, for being the warmer version, has been my favorite of the two, the one I'm most likely to wear. I've liked the pink tones in here. The mattes are pretty good, but once again, the longevity on this is not good. The shimmers are so creamy in here. They're the Super Shock formula. They crease in like 10 minutes, and I haven't even really loved the looks that I've come up with either of the palettes. They just don't look that good to me. I don't know. I haven't been tempted to reach for them, but because of that, I've been reaching for them more to just make sure I'm not going crazy, but yeah, I'm not a fan of them. I thought I was going to be. I thought they looked really pretty, but I don't enjoy wearing them. I don't enjoy applying them. So yeah, those are 12 and 11. Number 10 is from Natasha Denona, What a Sin. But honestly, it's not for lack of quality, but, you know, in my own personal rankings, I'm just not in love with this palette. So this is the Natasha Denona Mini Bronze Palette. It's a great way to try Natasha Denona without breaking the bank. It's $27 compared to, you know, her $130 palettes. Quite a good deal. I'm just not into these bronzy tones right now. And not only that, I feel like this is a very repetitive palette from Natasha Denona. Now, this is very personal, but I do have the bronze palette from Natasha Denona, and with this palette, I can literally get the exact same looks that I can get from the bronze palette. So Natasha Denona advertised this as an extension. To me, it's not an extension. I can get the same look that I get with this in the bronze palette already. And there are 5 shades in here, but honestly, I have found every single look that I do looks the same, especially since there is only 1 shimmer. So if I pop that shimmer on, the looks all instantly look the same. The only different kind of looks I get is matte versus shimmer. And if you use the darkest color all over the lid. So for me, it's lack of variety and originality here. I don't really like where she went with the bronze colors that she chose in this specific palette. However, I do recommend this if you want to try Natasha Denona's formula because the quality is really good and you really, really do like a bronze look and you don't own the midi bronze, or you want to travel with the midi bronze palette, buy this instead. But for me, I was in love with it, if I'm being honest. Okay, so here is where things take a turn. Palettes I am really enjoying from this point on. Like this, while it is ranking number 9, I still really enjoy this and I do recommend it. It's just, we had some really good ones launch this month. So this is the Nomad Cosmetics Provence palette. So here's what it looks like. So cute. It's inspired by France and I love the color story here. So this is actually, to me, one of the most exciting and inspiring palettes of this video. But the reason that I'm not ranking it towards the top is because there was a few quality issues with the shades. Like this shade I wasn't too crazy about, and just a couple other shades, like the pastels up here kind of disappeared. So for that reason, it just can't rank towards the top. I still do recommend it if you love the color story, but just know not every shade is perfect. I've tried so many good quality palettes this month. I couldn't put this towards the top. Color story wise, this is towards the top, but there really are just better palettes that launched this month. I really love Nomad Cosmetics. I really do think that they curate some of the best and most pretty palettes, but sometimes, you know, quality is not really there. And I really do believe that they've improved their quality for sure. I really do like this palette. I don't want you to think I don't just because it's ranking low. It is quite a good palette. There's just a few inconsistencies in here, so I couldn't rank it higher than the palettes that simply just had better quality. But as I stated before, it is lovely. Number 8, this is a really good one. This is from Pat McGrath. This is the Midnight Voyage Mini Eyeshadow Palette. So there is only one new shade in here and the rest were pre-existing. So I had 5 of the 6 shades already in this palette, which is why this is ranking more towards the bottom because it wasn't as exciting for me. However, I think the quality in this palette is really, really great and it is a great way to get a tidbit of Pat McGrath's formula without having to break the bank. And you really can't get anything more travel friendly than this guy right here. I did not like the shade that they added that was not in any other palette because there was nothing unique about it. I don't know why there was going to be one new exciting shade and it wasn't even exciting, but something about the quality in this is so good. This shade right here in the Big Mothership palette that it came from is not very good quality. I swear this one is better quality than in the Mothership palette, and it's a purpley color story that's still neutral, so of course it's right up my alley as well. So if you are looking into getting this, I mean, the packaging is really, really cheap and terrible, but the quality of these shadows that are inside is so good. I really do love this color story. It's only ranking towards the bottom because I already have these colors, so yeah. But if you're interested in this, so good. But also the packaging is really cheap. That's also why it's ranking lower, but whatever. Number 7 is the ColourPop and BT21 palette collab. I haven't done a video or anything of this, but I've done a handful of looks with this palette. This is the Bon Voyage palette. It's a really good palette from ColourPop. I do find that with their collaborations, they tend to have a better formula. And you just get a wide variety of colors here. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I wanted to rank this even lower because I don't love the color story on this for some reason. Like, I am more attracted to the Nomad Cosmetics palette, but I'm so impressed with ColourPop's quality in here that it pushed it up a little bit for me. And that's not to say I don't like the color story, it's just visually it's not as pleasing to me, but I've created so many looks with it that I can't complain. If you use these shades right here, they will stain your eyelids, but I mean, I really love the colors that they've gotten in here. It's inspired me to create a ton of different looks. It's a large palette. There's a lot of different colors and color stories that you can get out of this, which I really like. So this palette contains a lot of versatility. I do believe this did sell out. So if it does come back and you're interested in the color story, I really do think you will like it. The quality is very, very solid for ColourPop. It's one of their better formulas. I mean, I've done blue looks, I've done rosy gold looks, I've done pink looks, purple looks. I've really done it all with this palette, and that versatility alone is also pushing it towards, it's not even towards the top. I've just tried so many good palettes, but it really is a good one from ColourPop. So if you can get your hands on it, I do recommend it. I've had a lot of fun with this. If I do a new at ColourPop video, I'm gonna feature this. I'm gonna say nothing but positive things about it because it really is such a good palette. Number 6 is from Sydney Grace. This is one of the 2 new palettes that launched during their sale. I freaking love this. So the quality is so good. I cannot say anything bad about Sydney Grace's quality. The only thing is, and it's funny because last year I would have ranked this so much higher because I was in love with the color story, but now I've had so many color stories like this in my collection that it's not as exciting for me. The following palettes after this are just so much more exciting to me than this, but this is a solid palette that's going to get a ton of use for me. It came out during their Christmas in July sale, and if you are interested, I definitely do recommend it, especially if you like those green and gold tones, and it still is overall a very wearable palette. Yeah, I mean, I don't have anything bad to say. This is just where it fell. And I do think the following palettes will explain why. So number 5 for this month is from Glam Light, and this is the Michaela Pot 2 palette. Now, is this going to be my most used palette in this video? No, I am not going to use this palette a ton. Oh my gosh, I can't get this out. Hold on. I am not going to end up using this palette a ton, which is why I couldn't put it towards the top. But it arguably is the most beautiful palette in today's video. I mean, these rich tones right here are incredible. And you guys, I did a whole review and two looks with this palette, and both of the looks that I created were insane. I really like how the matte formula is blendable here. Sometimes they can overblend, but just be careful, you'll be fine, pack it on. And the shimmers, they do crease really quickly if you have a lot of creases in your eyelids. But it's a beautiful palette, very easy to work with. You get stunning looks. It's just a little too dark and grungy, so not towards the kind of looks that I'm creating and wearing all the time. So for that, it's ranking at number 5. But if you do love this color story and you do think that you're going to get your use out of it, definitely do recommend it. But for me, it's not one I'm going to reach for a lot, but I'm really excited about the looks that I created, so that's why it's ranking where it's ranking. Number 4 is a palette that, you know, it's not the most exciting to look at, but it's one that I've reached for a lot and I've really enjoyed my experience with. This was one of the palettes that I tried last month. This is the Wingos, the Luxury Eye Palette in Smoky Quartz. If you want that effortless, easy 90s kind of smoky eye, this will give it to you with ease. The quality on this is phenomenal. You don't get a ton of looks with this palette, but honestly, the look that you get is so beautiful with it and easy to do that I absolutely love it. It has taken that simple 90s smoky eye and made it effortless, easy to create. The shadows remind me a lot of Tom Ford here, which is a big, big statement, like the good shadows from Tom Ford, by the way. So this is a very Tom Ford-esque palette where it's effortless and it's elegant. And I think Wingos killed it with this one, but you have to like the look that you get with this. You have to like that cool tone, smoky kind of eye with this. It still is wearable. It's not like a black smoky eye by any means, but it gives you that smoky yet elegant look, and it's a really great quality palette. So I've enjoyed my time with this. I'm continuing to wear it, and the looks that I get are just so good. I love my makeup every time I wear that palette, so I had to rank it up towards the top. Number 3. Okay. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. This is the Pat McGrath Moonlit Seduction palette. I'm biased in my ranking. It's a Pat McGrath Mothership palette. I want to rank it towards the top. It's not my favorite Mothership palette, though. From Pat McGrath, in the rankings of Mothership palettes, it's not towards the top. But Pat does no wrong with the quality. I'm biased. I love her Mothership palettes. I haven't gotten a ton of use out of this. You know, I did my original review of it. I hated the look that I did, but it was like a review look. Today, I'm wearing the palette. Love the look that I did. I've only used it these 2 times. It's a palette I want to continue using. I've just, my parents are here, so I haven't had a lot of time to play with it. This is a hesitant 3rd place. I'm gonna continue using this and will continue to update you, but I think that the glimmery shades in here are absolutely stunning. The only thing is, I wish they were a little bit different. They're all kind of in that same depth range where they're very light. They're so glittery and reflective, they're not gonna look that much different on the eyelids. You guys know where I stand with these 2 matte shades. I'm sick of them. I don't really like how warm those 2 shades pool on my eyelids. Literally almost red. I don't like that look in the crease all the time. Maybe for some looks, like these 2 are great, but I don't have many options with the crease shades. The only matte shade that I like in here is this. And this is the only matte shade that I have in this look. Imagine if I put a red in. I just don't want that warm element. It's kind of random. And she has them in every single palette. I'm over it. I know some of you love these shades. I know these shades don't pull as red on deeper complexions, but for me and my rankings, I'm tired of having a red in my crease for every Pat McGrath look. I'm not interested. I'm reaching for different crease shades in other palettes when I use this palette. You know, when it comes to Mothership palettes, this is why I buy them. And this is why they're one of my all time favorite formulas, which puts them towards the top, but it's still not my favorite palette from Pat McGrath. But if you don't have a ton of Pat McGrath palettes, this is a great option. It is a very pretty one, but I would still push you in the direction of other palettes personally. I'm just not as inspired. I just think some of the shades are a bit random to me and my workflow when it comes to applying eyeshadow. But that being said, I am going to continue to create looks. This look today, I mean, I love it. Great experience. It's Pat McGrath. the best quality. The quality is what puts it at the top automatically without me even liking the color story. But not my favorite Pat McGrath palette. And I know I'm being tough on Pat McGrath. I'm being a tough critic for sure. But genuinely, I don't like the matte shades in here. Okay, number two is the Glam Light and Michaela Volume 1 palette. So I did show part two, the Volume 2 palette. I ordered the Volume 2 and I had the Volume 1 sitting in my makeup collection, but I hadn't tried it yet. So when I ordered Volume 2, I instantly started digging into Volume 1 so I could compare them. I like Volume 1 better just because of the color story. What I said about the Glam Light Volume 2 palette stays true. The mattes can overblend, but they're still a really great, easy to use formula. The shimmers crease, but they're so beautiful, I do not care. For me, this is ranking at number 2 simply because I like this color story better. There's some more neutrals, it's a little bit more daytime friendly. I like the pops of color, they're not so deep and grungy and jewel toned, which is not normally what I'm going for. So I like the color story better. I think this palette is so awesome. The colors are so pretty. You can get really great looks with this palette. There's a lot of variety here, and totally late, but this was my favorite palette that I tried this month. It is so fun. I mean, I've had the most fun time creating looks, and I like that there's still a neutral aspect for days that I'm going out and I don't want my makeup to look crazy. Okay, the number one palette that I've tried in the last 2 months, kind of predictable to you, I bet, but the ABH Nouveau palette. I mean, this is me in a neutral palette. It's neutral, but you can still play around a little bit. You know, it's got kind of those fairy vibes, which I very much like. There's cool tones, a couple warm tones to mix it up, but it's mostly cool tone. This shade right here instantly makes this palette one of my favorites. You have greens and browns. I feel like there's a lot of variety given that it is a neutral palette. It's the new modernized version of the ABH palettes. The quality is really great. I mean, I've waxed poetic about this for so long that I almost feel like it's redundant. I feel like I've had this in my collection for a lot longer than I have. I can't believe it's only been 2 months, but it killed it. I'm still loving this. I'm not wearing it as much now because I've been testing all of the new palettes, but that is a staple in my collection. Will always be in my collection, and I will always reach for it for vacations, special events, and all of that good stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found that helpful. Those are all of the palettes ranked from worst to best. You disagree? Do you agree? I mean, there's some that I'm unsure about this ranking. Like, I do feel really guilty about Nomad. I feel like it should rank higher. And the Pat McGrath, I'm still uneasy about. It could go either way. I could end up loving it. I could end up not liking it as much. It's a little too early to tell, but I will keep you updated. You know, I'm always keeping you guys in the loop with my Pat McGrath palette usage. So anyways, thank you guys so much for liking this video and being subscribed to my channel. Catch you guys in the next one. Bye guys. Have a good one.